Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play RimWorld Alpha 13 and Cougar's Hope. And it's been a long time since I recorded. I was watching Vapa play RimWorld today, his last episode from his series, and our final episode, and just kind of gave me the urge to turn this game on. I really can't play another round or another game of RimWorld while I'm recording a series, because I end up spending all the time second guessing whether I did this in that one or in this one, and it kind of gets annoying for me and for you. And this time is going to be a little bit frustrating too, because I just got done recording this episode and went to edit it and waited for my voice to start, and it never started. My mic was on mute. It's been a long time since I've recorded, so kind of forgotten what to check before diving into this. Anyway, I kind of wandered through the map before I turned this on to remind myself what we were doing last, and man, we left this place a mess. This was the scene of a rather bloody prison break last time, all because I forgot to close the door, so Michael informed me afterward. Apparently, when we had that heat wave come through and everyone was almost dying, I had to get them out of the super hot prison into the cooler infirmary, so I just told these to be prisoner beds. And for some reason, it was needed to lock the door open to make this happen faster, or one of these rooms were not turning back into a prison like they were supposed to, or they were not obeying the command or something. So I did that for some reason and then forgot about it. And all of these juicy, tempting weapons sitting outside the open door of the prison was just finally too much. I mean, it was like two episodes open. It finally was too much for these guys to resist. I've got to hand it to them. They held back for a long time. We need a door there. So let's see. That would be a granite door, not an auto door. So, tell you what, let me just talk about a few things I did between episodes, and then I'll zoom back out and let you guys just watch while I'm kind of filling you in on what I've been up to the last few weeks. I did expand in here a zone for plasteel and silver, the idea of getting it out of here, which is not going to happen until I take this down to important. I also, over here, made a dedicated zone just for components and a dedicated zone just for plasteel. Vapa needs a treatment. I think he's got gutworm or something. So hopefully I've got quite a few people set to haul. So hopefully we'll get lots of stuff moved in and out. There is a few things I need to force being accomplished though. These guys need to get brought in. Cassie, can you bring in these? And give me a third one. Manuel, bring in the rest of the medicine. We were really low on medicine, but we had some harvest over here. This is about to harvest over here too. So, short of getting another trader soon, we've at least got some herbal medicine in. And these are the two that were injured with the jailbreak. Cathra was in here. She also got hurt from the jailbreak, but she's fine now. And otherwise, what? I went through and set the turrets back in so they could start concentrating on these again. Failed to recruit and set the doors in this area. I think we are pretty well caught up now. I reset the home zone and the animal no kill box zone, or what, no trenches zone, or whatever it called that, to animals no trap zone. There was a little bit of discrepancy there where they were able to get to some of the traps. So that's all been cleaned up. I've got two people set for cleaning, and they did a great job. All the blood went away. Amazing. Going to get this workbench rebuilt, which Radar is not working on. Who is a good... Rokes is a good constructor. Can you get working on this one first? And I've got Rokes and Nettie set for constructing. They should be able to get through the last of the Memorial Garden over here for Ronnie. And hopefully nobody else needs to get set over there for that. And I need to make sure that we are actually butchering animals. Natalia is not sleeping. Where is she at? She's not eating. She's... I don't know. Natalia, where are you at right now? Work. You are where nowadays? You're right there. You are sleeping. I didn't go down low enough. I only went to here. All right, so you are asleep. Needs 11 in the morning. You guys all have your sleep schedules kind of messed up. We got turrets on. Let's have you go ahead and get started. I want you to do some butchering. I want to get all these guys butchered and out of here. You guys are turned on Y. Ah, these got built. Let me show you the pathway there. Architect, power, conduits. We've got, this is the anti-sapper defense system. Actually, I have one more than I really need in there. And if the sappers come in with grenades, blow a hole in the wall, run in thinking they're inside, and they're not, they're going to go boom, 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 and they're going to die. But if they continue throwing grenades and take out a conduit, then everything on the far side of a conduit goes dead. So you hit the right one, they're free and clear to continue their way in. So I put power at this end with a switch, and then at this end with a switch, so that you blow up anything in the middle, and this side still powers this, and this side is still powered over here. So redundant systems will keep this up and running. But those redundant systems all both have to be turned off to save power. Same thing over here. Let's see, how do we get back there? This guy, he's not completely finished yet. But eventually, is there something in there? There is, you just can't see it. So eventually we're going to see a loop that does this and a switch right there, as well as a switch right here. So, redundant system in that area. I don't remember what's going on here. I really don't. How are we going to power that? Well, we'll figure that out another time. Anyway, so that's what is going on. Let me see if I can get caught up otherwise without a raid or something coming in. But I've been off not running the channel for, I think, 6 weeks now. Working on projects at home, working on my business, trying to get a little bit of a boost there and get that up and running a little better. YouTube takes a lot of time away from what I used to do on a normal daily basis. I used to spend my evenings working on my business. I spend my evenings creating videos now. So the business has really taken a nosedive, so I've got to get that one up and running again and keep us going. Otherwise, there'll be no more business or YouTube. But what was that? Social wooed by Eric. Rokes rejected. Okay. And anyway, so working on home, working on business, working on my new studio. I finally got one room emptied. Another room moved into that space, clearing a space for what will eventually be my final studio. I'm right now in what I would consider a temporary studio, what I'm calling Rambler Studio A. Well, I'm building Rambler Studio B. Rambler Studio A is in a space that is not heated and not cooled and will eventually be probably a laundry room. Take out the back wall, open up into the main hallway, and so with a couple of sliding doors, or actually folding doors, like accordion doors, and open up into a washer, dryer, sink, and a linen closet kind of a place. But I needed a studio, and I needed a space that was quiet, and so a year and a half ago, this space became that, or that space became this, something like that. And so it's a small little 5x7 room, and blankets are hung up on the walls to try to deaden some noise, and it's not the best place to be, but it has worked. Brand, I need you to bring these in. Thanks. And it's time to get into something more permanent. So I've got an area that I'm working on. I'm screwing soundboard to the walls to deaden the sound. I built a partition wall to go in. Just two nights ago, put a switch on that partition wall that'll be alongside the desk. that I'll be able to flip a switch and a light will come up in the hallway. And actually, I wired it to an outlet in the hallway rather than a lamp socket, so that I can put in a on-the-air lit sign later. That'd be kind of fun. But just going through and designing the room from scratch. I'm going to build a desk out of 2x10 planks. So real thick, dense, heavy desk. And then I'll put a sheet of birch plywood over the top of that. And so a real deep, heavy desk rather than this hollow plastic table I'm using now that echoes everything like a drum that I do in here. So it'll be a much nicer space when it's done. Carpeting on the floor, soundboard on the ceiling. I should be able to run without any issue of sound when I'm done. The CPU will be down below and in a sound deadened space, so I won't hear the fans anymore. So it should be working pretty good when it's all finished, but all that takes a lot of time. So that's one of the projects I've been working on while I've not been recording. But I enjoy running this YouTube channel. I enjoy making the videos. I enjoy playing video games. So 6 weeks away from the computer, well, we all knew that wasn't going to happen. So I got to playing Skyrim. I haven't played Skyrim in a long time. It used to be my all-time favorite game. And just watching what's happening here while I'm talking. I can't do anything important while I'm talking or I'll do both of them poorly. I'm not a multitasker, including noticing that my mute button was off last time, but looks like everything's running fine now. So I started playing Skyrim. That's something that I wanted to do. In fact, it's one of the reasons I started this channel, was I wanted to do what Briarstone was doing. Someone who I was watching a couple years ago. I haven't seen much of his stuff lately, but a couple years ago I was watching him, and he was doing something, because I was interested in Skyrim back then, and he was creating a character and then playing out the character until the character died. I thought, you know, that's a great way to play Skyrim. It makes you play smart. It makes you not take risks that are uncalculated or are foolish. You know, as if you were actually there and actually in that situation. Can you handle that or can you not? Is it time to run? Or is it time to take cover and do a sneak attack? Or what does it take to survive this situation? So I decided that, you know, I've been wanting to do that all this time. It was time to finally do it. So played Skyrim for a bunch of hours and really enjoyed it and decided to hit the record button. And created a character and had a ball. So I've now got a 10-episode Skyrim, kind of a mini-series, fully recorded, that I want to release all at once. Kind of like Netflix releases a whole season at once. You can sit down and just binge-watch the whole thing. Right there, machinery struck. Let's get that marked. Orders. Probably that group there. And then I found out that, you know, something I hadn't realized before, because I've never recorded a game that has quite the sounds of Skyrim. When you turn Skyrim on and you get that big boom, boom, boom at the very beginning, real deep rumbling, at least with my subwoofer on, it, you know, it kind of rattles the walls. And I thought, ooh, I like that sound. So I wanted my little video intro for the series to be based on that sound. Well, I went to edit and render that sound to find that my Corel Video Studio 9 doesn't do well with those kind of noises. So, you're down, and you're down. Well, we've got two builders going. They'll grab components and take care of it eventually. Eric's probably doing it already. Yeah, fuel generator. He knows the important one, although turrets are pretty important too. So it recorded in kind of a warbly noise, like you're hearing it underwater. You know, something was going wrong with the rendering. So I talked to Klaus, KLCBsoft. Klaus, where are you? This Klaus in here. He's my advisor extraordinaire for anything technical. He's really good at this stuff. And he was scratching his head at that too, because what I did should have worked. So a bunch of experiments later and research later, turns out that this has been a problem with Corel Video Studio for a long time. I'm using version 9, and they were having problems with it back in version 4, and apparently have just never fixed it. So one of the forums provided a workaround that I tried, and it worked. I tried a few other things, too. I tried creating movie version, MOV, and a few other versions, and some worked good, but the package was so big. It was like 40 times the size of the file size. Or another one, the sound came out great, but it couldn't handle the whipping around of the camera. Because in Skyrim, you don't move like this. You swing 180 degrees and yell, "What was that?" So that particular one couldn't handle it. So this is kind of an older version of MP4 that I'm using now. In fact, I'll be rendering this one in it. That can handle it. And so what I decided to do was edit and render all of those episodes in a much higher quality than I've done in any of the other episodes of the series, of the channel. So I'm normally running at 8,000 kilobytes per second. I've ran this one at 15,000 kilobytes per second. So much higher quality for the camera motion and the little sounds. I also upped the sound quality to twice the quality that I usually run. It makes for much bigger videos, much bigger files, and much longer rendering time and much longer upload time. So it's not something I can do every day for the channel because it just takes way too long to create content. But for this series, I wanted to do that. I wanted a high quality, TV quality kind of a look to it. So I ended up with a 10 episode series, and I'm sitting there scratching my head saying, now what do I do with it? I want to release it all at once, but it's kind of a special circumstance. So I got to thinking about Patreon and trying to figure out how to generate a little bit of income with this channel to make up for the business that I'm losing by putting in the time to run the channel. Now I've got to find some kind of a balance between the two, or I'm going to have to really limit what I can do on YouTube so I can keep my business running. So got to looking more at Patreon. I mean, what do I really have to offer? I create videos and offer them for free on YouTube. So what is there that I can really sell on Patreon? It's not that easy. If I had a product that I sold or created and those who donate at a certain level get the product, well, that's a no-brainer, but this is not that way. So did a little looking around and thinking about it and research and what have you, and came up with some ideas. And I've just today updated the Patreon account to reflect that. I started the Patreon account because in my past, there have been YouTubers that I really enjoyed, and they did or said something that caught my attention, and I just wanted to send a donation their way. And I went looking and couldn't find any way to do that. They didn't have a mechanism set up for it. So there was no way to, and eventually I just kind of gave up and it never happened. So I got to thinking, many months ago, I should at least create some way for folks to do that for me in case they get this urge or this sense that they want to do something. At least I can have, something set up. It wasn't really an attempt to create an income for the channel. It was just something that seemed like the right thing to do, a proper thing to do, just a courtesy thing to do. And so I didn't put much effort or thought into it after that. And as a result, nothing has really happened after that. I've had one faithful patron this whole time, and I've been very thankful for what she's done. She's shown a little faith in what I've been creating here, but there wasn't any incentive to really go to it and do anything with it. So what I did was I set up a $3 a month tier that basically makes a person a patron, and they'll get access to comments and pictures and just little notices and announcements and things that I'll put on there. It's kind of the entry level. I'm just letting you guys watch the game back here while I'm talking. I'm trying to keep track of it too while I'm talking. At the $5 level, this is where Skyrim comes in. I was trying to figure out how I could release it and reward patrons first with special events and special series like this Skyrim series. How do I do that? And I found out that Patreon is not very intuitive. You don't look around the Patreon site and figure it all out. You end up having to Google your questions to figure out how to do it. Passing by. Okay, doesn't affect us. Like, how do you post links to an unlisted YouTube video to your patrons? No, I didn't see any obvious way to do it. You can post, but it didn't tell me what I can do with that post. So I figured I would have to send direct emails to everybody every time I wanted to give them first access to a video, and that seemed kind of annoying. So I finally Googled it to find out that you can choose. Let's do this. Right there. We want to get the ship built. In fact, let's go with propulsion. We use the engine as a power source for the colony. I want to get a ship built either in this area or this area soon. So let's keep that one in mind here. But what I found out is that you can post something to Patreon, and then you get to choose whether it's going to be public, or whether it's going to be for all patrons, or whether it's going to be for a specific price range. And that I didn't know. So I realized I did have a way to send a note, a message, and put links in there for a special announcement or a first episode of a series, of a brand new series coming out, or something, some special event that I can use to say thank you to those who support me on Patreon. So with that, I came up with the idea that Skyrim, the series, is going to first be released to patrons, and that'll be at the $5 level, as well as every level above that. It's all accumulative. So that's one way I'm going to, from here on out, reward patrons. Give them a little special something once in a while. It'll eventually hit YouTube, and everybody else will get to see it too, so nobody misses out. You just get that first peek, you know, that sneak peek at it. And then the $10 level. Right now, I'm playing games like this one, or I'm going to do Oxygen Not Included, I hope. Maybe right after this one, in between this and the next RimWorld series. That's kind of the idea of how it might go down. Games that allow me to rename characters. So $10 would put you first on the list to be a named character. Now, I'm not expecting Patreon to fill up anytime soon, if ever. It's more of just an experiment to see how this goes. So I would imagine there'll be three or four for a while soon, and you know that'll be it. So there'll be plenty of room to grab subscribers to fill in the rest of these games for named characters. But $10 level will grant a place, a guaranteed place in the list of names for characters. And that's all I have posted so far. There is a $15 level I'm thinking about. In fact, we're kind of experimenting with that right now, of creating some merchandise. What I'm thinking of, well, I asked Mrs. Rambler about it. What on earth could we sell? What on earth could we put out there that people would want? I mean, I don't know that I'd really walk around parading a shirt called Vapa Gaming on it, and everyone would stare at me going, what's that? So, just pop my name out there, it doesn't really mean anything, except for, to 1,118 subscribers, and so it's got to be something that's functional and interesting and whatnot. So she popped up with an idea that I had never even heard of before. She said, how about mug rugs? I said, what? Mug what? A mug rug. We've got an Etsy store, and one thing that she makes are potholders, and it's kind of like a potholder, but think of a rectangular one, a little narrower, a little longer than your typical cooking potholder that you can put your mug down on, your coffee cup on one side, and a stack of cookies on the other side, and sit back and flip on the TV or YouTube and relax and enjoy yourself. Well, what if we had some mug rugs to choose from with different sayings from the channel? It might be kind of interesting. So I want to come up with two or three designs first and actually make them. And then post that and see what folks think, and maybe make that the $15 tier, reward tier for Patreon. And I've got a t-shirt idea that does look like it could be a little bit of fun. That might be the $20 level, which also includes all the previous levels too, so you still get the sneak peek, the videos, and a name character and all that. So that is something that that is up and coming. In fact, the first three levels are up and running right now. If you want to pop over and just peek at it and see how that all works, and see if it's something that interests you, or at least to go over and check it out and give me your thoughts, you know, whether there's a way to improve what I've done and make this work. But there's got to be a way to convert the hundreds, if not thousands, of hours so far in that I put into this gaming channel into a little bit of an income stream to kind of offset what I'm not putting into my business anymore. So I'll leave all that with you, just, you know, his thoughts of what I've been doing the last few weeks, you know, from working on the house and the studio and the business and the Skyrim series and Patreon, and there's probably a dozen other things I can't think of right now. But with all of that as introduction, what are we at, 25 minutes into this? It's time to probably get into this episode. So what is going on here? We had a siege a couple episodes ago that fired over here and bombed us pretty good. I see this is in. Great. Where's Eric at? Is he sleeping? Eric, he's sound asleep. Yeah, the siege, and then immediately after that, the jailbreak. And lots of injuries. It was a rough time. So, I see the Silversmith Hall. Great. Did the weapons get out of here? They did not. Do we have space? We have a little bit of space. Bran, before you go and talk to Hippo, can you get this charge rifle the heck out of here? Thank you. Who else can do this? Let's get the temptations away from the jail door. Kethra, you're probably cleaning. You're cleaning dirt. Let's get you to do that. In fact, we're pretty dirt-free right now. Yeah. Work. Kethra, you are cleaning. You're down here. Let's do that and get you on hauling. Brand is cleaning when he's not repairing or wardening. Okay. So Brand's already got a number one job. And he's going to go talk to Hippo again. Nettie and Dwayne. Dwayne, you are hauling. Can you haul this shotgun, please? And he's someone else to haul this knife. Klaus, come on over here. And before you go to sleep, why don't you put this away? All right, I feel much better about that. We are in the middle of summer. And we're still running a hothouse here. Let's get that turned off. Designate off. Heater is turned off. And let's get this roof opened up. Zones. No roof zone. And again, this is Alpha 13, so it's instant for me. Everybody else has to wait for workers to come over and tear the roof down. All right, so what else needs to be accomplished besides building a ship? Probably could work on the... Well, I don't know how big the ship's going to be. I think I want to lay out the skeleton and then build around it. Kind of put a barrier. That may not be truly necessary, though. Don't know. We'll approach that when it happens. But I got the silver out of there, which made me space. I can't think of anything else critical that's happening right now. Let me go through my notes here. We still have the challenge of Dwayne racing a starved charging bear to impress Cassie. And what else is floating out there? I was asked to tame some wild boars. Is Rabbit still on taming? He's on handling, yeah. Do we have any wild boars left? The heat wave took out a lot. We also had another toxic fallout recently, too. We've had a lot of stuff hit all at once. That's right, and it seems like it piled up all on those, like, two or three episodes. You, double-click, I got two. Let's tame these guys. Failing can be dangerous. Yep. All right, any others? Let's get, like, four as a possibility. I see a llama. I see boom-booms. No. There's not a lot in the way of animals at all out here, are there? rabbits or boom booms. Tortoise 6. And you're blue. What does that mean? Did they come in with a caravan or something that got harmed by the siege and he got left behind? I wonder if it's something like that. Blue usually means visiting. And we don't have a tortoise 6 right now. I can tame him, so he's not ours. Odd. Got a lot of resources down here. Michael has been busy. And Klaus was our other miner, right? Klaus. Yeah, right there. And you are set to that, right? Repair, grow. No, okay, so let's do that. I want to get as much mining done as possible. We're going to be short uranium if the formula for the ship is the same in 13 as 16 that I'm seeing out there in Vapa's and Cathra's games. Critical alert. You are Dwayne, who needs is parasite treatment. Okay. Medicine sitting on 30. And a bunch sitting out here. That was traders. A trade caravan. Ooh. Doesn't say exactly what kind, so I guess it's just a general goods. Who can do some hauling? Vapa, you are going to consume a lavish meal. If you're sick, your mood's probably a little low, so I'm going to leave you to do that. Radar, you are hauling. Great. Can you haul these in? Because that's pretty important. And for that matter, Cassie, you're going for a walk. Why don't you walk over this way and get those in as well? These also need to get brought in. We've got half a summer and an autumn left, and we've got an empty fridge, so we really need to think about... We need to think about food. And these guys still have not been butchered. What's it gonna take to get them butchered? All right, let's shut down. Let's think about things here. Lavish. Let's suspend that one. This one. Fine. Lavish. Suspend that one. What was this other one? It was fine. Okay, so two fines. So we're just going to do some lavish. But at that, let's even suspend it from that one. Who do we have cooking? We should have Natalia, who's hunting first. Then she drops down to her twos, which is cook. And then art. Okay. She is sleeping. Yes. Rabbit was a cook. Bran was a cook. Bran, your cook is a two. After cleaning, that'll probably never happen. Well, it's possible. Cleaning is basically done. And then Rabbit, who I really wanted to be able to get to some other things. But let's go ahead. Actually, who did we need to train up? It was Radar. But Radar is on... No, Manuel is on... research. Radar. Cook. Was it you? It was not. Who was it? Rabbit. Cassie's a 5.5. No, that's hunting. Cook. Radar 3. Natalia 17. Bran 6. Oh, Radar had a passion for it. At the very beginning, we were desperate to find things that he had a passion for. To keep his mood up, because he came in pretty limping there. Okay, let's get Brand then to drop back into cooking after wardening. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, Brand's there, Rabbit is there, Natalia is there. As soon as somebody wakes up who's got the capacity to do this, I need to get that butchering done. And there were no other animals. There haven't been any all episode. Here's our troop over here. When Brand gets up, we'll have him start there. He's our socialite. Nope. Tortoise 8 and Tortoise 6. What is this? That looks blue to me. Compared to these guys. That is definitely white. These guys are blue. But their animals are not. Hello. Just kind of wandering through here. Oh, we had a fire in there, didn't we? There's more doors left open. Okay. Yeah. It's like Night Ghost playing 7 Days to Die. Always leaving the doors open. Never know what's going to wander into his place. Used to razz him about that on his Twitch stream. Anyway, these guys are coming in. Martinez up there. Where's Brand? Brand, how much sleep have you had? Yeah, I'll leave you alone for a little bit longer. That's odd. I always thought right-click got rid of this, but right-click is not doing it. Right-click does it on oxygen not included, but not on this one. Just like this one increases speed, you hit 2 and 3 in 1, whereas that one you hit tab. So I've been playing a lot of that one. I'm really enjoying that game. So I've gotten pretty good at it too. I've gotten where I can maintain and balance out and just keep it going. And so that is a series I definitely will be bringing to the channel. I'm guessing after this one. We need to get the ship built. Because we need Alpha 13 to be retired soon. Really do. I'm enjoying the game. I'm enjoying, you know, the interaction of the characters and the interaction in the comment sections afterwards. So the age of the game isn't critical. It's what you do with the game that is. And we've done a good job with it. But it would be nice to eventually start a current Alpha. So do need to get Alpha 13 finished. But oxygen not included, which it has many similarities to a game like RimWorld, is something that I want to bring to the channel. And I am enjoying it. You are doing what, Rokes? You're building traps. Okay. Okay. So we do have these guys going in. Turrets. These turrets are off. Those are off. These are off. These are all off. That repair got done. That repair got done. Just talking my way through all of this. We have Martinez waiting for us over here. Martinez and Martinez. I have heard that pronounced both ways. Yeah, that's Martinez. Brand, it's time. Come on up here. Talk to Martinez for me. Trade. Here we go. And do we have an Natalia yet? No, but you've been sleeping long enough. Let's get you butchered. And Brand Rabbit. Colonist needs treatment. Okay. So I'll leave Rabbit alone. He's going to be doing some medical work here in Cassie soon. All right. So with that, Brand is about to go say hi. And where am I at? Close to 40 minutes. Let's get this trade going. And we'll decide what's going to happen after that. What on earth are you? A uranium small sculpture. Ooh, they'll buy all the clothes. They haven't got a lot of money. Let's clean house. Let's clean house. Let's get rid of almost everything. We have got so much fur and hide and wool and what have you here. Let's clean out all of this old stuff. Start up here. We have a little marble statue pour that has to do with Trebo. And we should keep a memory of Trebo here. She was with us for most of the series in bed. So, crippled in bed. So, yeah, we need to keep that one. But we can get rid of. Is there anything here I don't want to get rid of? Cowboy hats work good for heat waves. So let's keep a couple of cowboy hats. That one too. So I can get rid of all of these. Yeah. Kevlar helmet, awful. That's theirs. Okay, that's not ours. Okay. Anything else down here that we need to keep? You are. Psychic foil. We need to keep you. Alright, so keep you. Helmet 61. There may be another helmet down there. I'll get rid of that one. Awful. Okay. So, otherwise, everything else here can be gone. That left. Psychic foil. That didn't work. Alright, back up here. What in this group do I need to keep? Armor vest. I'll bet you there's more down there. All right, going through this list here, I'm not really seeing anything that's critical to keep. All right, all these are gone. Can I just run that? I can't. Darn. If I hold the shift button and do that. Nope. Control? Nope. Okay. 30 clicks later, I'll be done. All right, next group. Down here, 34%, 38%, 57, 69. Let's get rid of all these. They, so far, need to pay us 728. So we're doing fine there. Getting into more expensive stuff down here, though. All right. What do we got in this group? There we go. 63. And two of them at 76. We'll keep those. What else? So we're going to skip that one. That's a shoddy. Poor. Personal shield we'll keep. Personal shield we'll keep. All right. Let's get rid of that one. That one. I didn't miss it. I did. You go back. Okay. So that one, that one, that one. Everything else goes? Yeah. Now we've gone past their numbers, which is fine if we find something we want to buy. What else do we have to get rid of? Prosthetic leg? No, but they have an arm. This isn't the bionic ones. This is the prosthetic ones, which means that, ooh, there's a bionic eye, which means it's not as good, but it is a placeholder until you find what is good. So let's grab one of those as well. And the bionic eye, Kathra, needs that. We'll make her a sharpshootist. That'll increase the accuracy of her weapon use. So that we will take. Otherwise, what do we have to get rid of? Insanity Lance for keeping. They have glitter rolled medicine. 96 each, though. Ouch. Boy. Yes, but I'm going to set everybody down a notch so we can turn that on just for operations like the bionic eye. Okay, we'll do that. Otherwise, that finishes what we have to sell other than animals. Do we need all the animals? All of these are ours. 3, 6, 8, 10, 11, 12 turtles. Let's get rid of the more valuable ones. Yeah, we'll do... Well, I'll tell you what. We'll get rid of the babies. Keep the more adult ones. Just because they're ready to do something now. We've never really had a chance to fully explore the idea of a turtle kill box. You know, snapping turtle terror team. So let's keep enough to at least experiment with that once. Boomalopes. These are all ones. Okay, there was one up here too. So a calf and a pack of one. Zero. We have a baby. I think we had a baby. I didn't notice a pop-up. I get the sense we could sell off a boomalope or two. Let's get rid of that one. And calf. Get rid of a calf. And we'll get rid of an alpaca. We're only using them for wool, and we don't really need that. But anything that's named especially, like Snookums and Spirit, we don't want to get rid of. But they're both females. So it'd be nice to maintain one male. What am I looking for here? Alpaca male. No, alpaca female. Is there not a male alpaca here? Female. How did one of our females get pregnant? Is there something I'm missing here? Maybe they went roaming with some some wild ones out there. They have to sell us a couple of grizzlies and some snow hares. That's it. Okay. Components. Do it that way. Components. Yes, we'll take all of those. What else do they have to sell us? Over here, lances. And this is their stuff here. So that one we're already getting one of. Okay. Doomsday Rocket Launcher. No, don't think so. More of their items. They didn't bring a whole lot. So far, they're paying us 1,800 of their 28. So, if we had more to sell, we could. But I don't see it happening. A Kevlar Helmet, 107. No, I think we're doing fine. And, right? That was armor vests that we kept. I actually don't have another helmet. Alright, we'll go ahead and take that one. Where'd you go? That guy? That guy. I'll take one of you. Alright. Over here, gold, uranium, small sculpture, and a telescope. Now, I don't have a telescope, right? I think it was Vapa's game that I saw a telescope go in. Let's grab a telescope. So, we're going to come up with 1,400 extra. And clear out a lot of space. Yeah, I like that. They dumped that pause right out here. Bran, bring in the medicine, please. Bionic eye and the simple arm. Okay. And helmet. Alright, so we need to get all these things hauled in. Vapa, you are sewing area after you bring in the... I'll have you bring in the arm. And radar, you're filling that up. That'd be fine. Kathra, can you bring in your eyeball, please? Thank you. Radar, okay, you're dumping that off, but you can dump it right there. Can you bring in the helmet? That it? What are you? A telescope. Who wants to bring in the telescope? Eric, that's more of your scientific realm there. Why don't you bring in telescope? In fact, we could kind of install that somewhere, right? I'm thinking that goes into the memorial garden over here. Right there. Rotate? No. It does. Alright. Although it goes upside down. Okay, that looks kind of funky. So... Alright, then you are out over here. Perfect. In fact, let's... Where did Eric go? Boy, he zipped out of there. Which way did you take? There you are. Let's have you instead just install it. Okay. So with that, am I done? I think I am. We're getting lots of little things done that have been waiting for many episodes. There have been no major attacks landing on us. These are finished. And I do need to reset medicines. Get everybody off of Glitter World so I can use those specifically for really bad cases or for transplants. So I need to do that before someone uses it for their gut worm or something. So I think I'm going to call this one done. This has been Noble Rambler. Thanks, guys, for watching. And not sure when I'm going to get back to uploading on a regular basis. It's still going to be a few weeks to a month. Still a lot going on around here to kind of solidify the home income a little better. So it's kind of a busy time of year, and I need to take advantage of this while I can. But I'll still try to pop in an episode here and there, and in a week or so. In fact, right, just about a week. I'm thinking next weekend. This is Sunday. This is Easter. So next Saturday morning or Friday night, I want to release that Skyrim series to YouTube. But if you do want a sneak peek, you know how to do it. So I'll catch you next time, folks. Thanks. Bye-bye.